Move comes just days after the New York-based bakery announced it was going to close all of its stores due to declining sales. Lamona says that he plans to diversify and offer customers more than just cupcakes. Let's go now to Cleveland. It's a sports story that transcends sports. In fact, in that Midwest city, it could help lead a Rust Belt revival. The story, of course, is about basketball superstar LeBron James, whose odyssey back to his hometown sparked euphoria in one city and disdain in another. It is the opposite of what happened 4 years ago when LeBron left. And in some corners, there are questions. Should he have gone back? Joining me now is Jason Johnson, a professor at Hiram College, which is just outside of Cleveland. And just to be clear, though, this morning you're joining me from Atlanta. So yes. I'm just going to make that clear. Anyway, Jason, good to see you as always. I want to get your immediate reaction when you heard the news. What was it?
I was shocked. I was really shocked, and I was kind of disappointed. I had just been in Cleveland last week. No one there thought that LeBron was going to come back. My friends there, I mean, you know, but between the GOP convention and LeBron, this has just been the weirdest week in Cleveland in like 10 years. No one thought either of these things was going to happen.
Okay, but wait a minute. You said you're disappointed. Aren't you glad he's coming back to play for the Cavs?
You know, I'm glad for him because it's a good basketball move for him. But I and a lot of people who I talk to in the city, there's a strain of people in Cleveland who don't forgive Dan Gilbert for what he did. You know, before Donald Sterling, it was Dan Gilbert. That rant that he did against LeBron James seemed laden with a lot of sort of class and racial code language. Mm-hmm. It was really hostile. It was really unprofessional. And there's some people, and I'm one of them, as happy as I may be for the Cavs and for the city of Cleveland, I have trouble rooting for any team where Dan Gilbert will benefit.
Okay. You know, here's what he wrote. For anyone who doesn't know, it was a much different story then. He wrote, "You simply don't deserve this kind of cowardly betrayal," in his letter to the city. Okay, so he now says that James says, "I've met with Dan face to face, man to man. We've talked it out. Everybody makes mistakes. I've made mistakes as well. Who am I to hold a grudge?" So they've gotten past it, it should seem.
Well, yes, of course, because money's involved. I think, you know, the interesting thing to remember here, and again, there's a tremendous amount of money that LeBron will bring back to the city. It's great for his professional narrative. But what Dan Gilbert did, he didn't just go after LeBron James. He spearheaded the lockout against the players to rewrite the entire collective bargaining agreement with labor so that LeBron could never do something like that again. So it's very interesting that he got mad at him 4 years ago for going to create a super team, but now LeBron is back, there's plenty of cap space, and Dan Gilbert's about to do exactly what he was complaining about 4 years ago.
Okay. He seems to transcend sports, don't you think, LeBron James?
Yes.
Why do you think that is, and where does he fit on the pantheon of great sports figures?
By the time his career is over, and he's just turns 30 this year, so it'll be probably another 8 years, he will be pushing Michael Jordan and, dare I say, possibly Arthur Ashe territory. This is the first social media sports superstar that the United States has ever seen. He came from humble beginnings. He married his high school girlfriend. He's kept his nose clean. He's never been in any kind of trouble. He's great philanthropically. He is a global ambassador of the United States. And most recently, he's become very politically active during the Trayvon Martin Zimmerman trial and then recently with Donald Sterling. LeBron James is at the peak of his powers, and that's why people who generally could care less about basketball actually pay attention to what this guy does.
So do you see any downside for Cleveland or that part of Ohio, the region in general, for having him return, or is it all thumbs up good?
It is all thumbs up good. I mean, you know, first off, he's going to bring hundreds of millions of dollars back to the city. He's going to bring investment back to the city. He's going to, people like me, you know, when it's cold in Cleveland in December and you don't want to go downtown, we're going to go downtown to watch LeBron James now. It's going to be great. And what's particularly special about this is, even if he never wins a championship in the city, and I'm glad I'm down here, because if I said this back home, I'd be in trouble. Even if he never wins a championship, the amount of enthusiasm that he will bring back to Cleveland sports, it is a win-win for everybody involved, politicians, business people, and the fans.
So my executive producer, Nick, is from Cleveland. One of my producers, Bar, is from Cleveland. Oh, man, I'm going to never hear the end of it. I have to say, they're going to ditch me out and go to games and join you. And then where will I be? Anyway,
It'll be great.
Yeah, good for you guys. Jason Johnson, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Ahead, who is she? The latest on the 26-year-old.